Yes, welcome back. Off the Bench WA is back for 2016. It's great to be in your company again. It's all thanks to our very dear friends at McDonald's who have climbed on board again. Maccas is WA footy, and they are certainly proud of the fact that they are doing their utmost to grow the great game at all levels in WA. We have a massive show tonight to kick it off. We'll have a chat with the GM of the Western Australian Country Football League, Joe Georgiades. We'll have a then chat with the Boulder City star, Scotty Worthington, doing some great things in WA. And then we have a chat to the coach of South Bunbury, Mark Docking. They have a big game on the long weekend Monday, taking on Bunbury. That's 1v3. And we'll also have a chat with Ross Lanigan, our country footy reporting extraordinaire. Well, normally with this show, WA's favourite son, Scotty Cummings, sits beside me, but he's been unsighted, led to believe that, like a couple of other AFL players that changed clubs in the off-season, let himself go. So we've sent him away. He's gone to a camp, and we're expecting a trim and taut, terrific Scotty to return in a very short period of time. But in the meantime, a man that has appeared on this show before, he's synonymous with the West Coast Eagles, played in their 2006 Premiership team, 78 games, and doing a remarkably good job coaching the Western Bulldogs VFL team. I speak of Ash Hansen. Welcome back, Ash. Great to have you on board again.
Good to be here, Swatter. Very passionate about WA footy, so love talking
to you. Going to talk to you a little bit later on in the show with regards to the good form of the West Coast Eagles, but equally the disastrous season that is happening at the Fremantle Football Club. So we'll get your thoughts on that a little bit later on. But right now, let's kick it off with a man that runs all things WA country footy, and that man is Joe Georgiades, and he joins us on the line. Welcome, Joe. Thanks for joining us.
No worries at all. It's great to be back for another year, and I can't wait to see what Scotty's going to bring to the table in a few weeks' time.
Well, unless he gets himself fit, he's not coming back at any stage soon, Joe. So more importantly, from a WA country footy perspective, the Landmark Championships is a new format this year.
Yeah, it's been the talk of the town a little bit. We've changed it up. We've been thinking of changing it for a number of years, and this year the stars sort of aligned for us, so one of the benefits this year, there's going to be six games held in regional WA, 3 weeks out from the carnival. So that's going to happen on the 17th and 19th of June. So there's going to be some absolute cracking matches happening around the state. And then when the players do come to Perth in July, it'll be for a much shorter period. So we think there's a lot of advantages in that new model.
And as Swatter mentioned, Joe, it's a long weekend in WA this weekend, which offers the fixturing a fantastic opportunity to maximise this. What's going on in WA country footy off the back of this?
Look, with the long weekend starting in the north of the state, there's a Kimberley Colt Carnival. So there's a lot of great talent running around up in the Kimberley. So all those young boys will go to Fitzroy Crossing for a Colt Carnival. Lots of matches all over the state. Most of the guys would be happy to get their footy out of the way and then relax for the rest of the long weekend. I'm looking forward to getting down to Manjum up for the Imps versus Tigers match, so that'll be an interesting match. Plenty of good footy, and also the South Bunbury match, which I think you're going to touch on later in the show, which will be on the Monday. So really looking forward to that as well.
Hey Joe, it's a massive state, WA. It's a very big area with population spread all over that fantastic state. What about some of the distances some of the players and coaches and everybody involved in travelling clubs have to make? That would present some logistical challenges, one would think.
Oh yeah, definitely. And I think the fuel bills will certainly add up. We've got some guys in the Kimberley. It's not unusual for them to travel 4 or 5 hours to a game. In Exmouth, the Exmouth guys travel 4 hours to Carnarvon every second week. And just all over the state, it's not unusual to drive 2 or 3 hours for a game of footy. So a lot of effort and energy goes into the footy, but we certainly love it, and it's a really important part of country communities, that's for sure.
And Joe, WA is taking on the Crow Eaters on July 31. Can you give us a brief preview on the big clash?
Yeah, it's a really exciting opportunity for our state countryside. The best 22 players will travel across to Adelaide. They'll get to play on the new Adelaide Oval before the Crows-Essendon match. And, we're really excited about the group that we're starting to put together. And we think, we do owe the South Australians a couple of victories, so we're hoping this is going to be our year. But certainly, for any players out there that are keen to go on that trip, the first stage is to play really well in the Landmark Championships matches starting in 3 or 4 weeks in June.
Well, Joe, it's a big weekend coming up, not only in WA, but you've also got the state game coming up. Never thought I'd say this, but I hope WA beat the living suitcases out of a South Australian team. Thanks very much for joining us, and we hope that the 2016 right across your great state is a fantastic one.
Thanks a lot, fellas. Cheers.
There you go. Joe Georgiades joining us, and a lot to look forward to over a massive weekend of footy in WA. It's a long weekend over there. I tell you what, I don't know if you've ever heard of the name Scotty Worthington, but he's a Boulder City star, and he's going to join us when we come back, Ash. Just have a look at what some of the stuff that Scotty Worthington can do. Doing some amazing things for Boulder City. We're going to have a chat to that young man. We're also going to introduce for the first time today, tonight I should say, Roz Lanigan, reporting extraordinaire. Welcome back to Off the Bench WA, all thanks to our great mates at McDonald's. Time now to head around the state leagues. We just spoke with Joe Georgiades about a big weekend of footy coming up, and there's a big interleague match coming up as well this weekend. As we welcome for the first time this year, Roz Lanigan. Welcome, Roz.
Thank you for having me. Yeah, it'll be a huge weekend this weekend. After six rounds of the West Kimberley Football League, they will go into their interleague clash with the North Pilbara Football League tomorrow. Plenty of pride on the line in all interleague fixtures, as we know, boys, and you'd expect a pretty fast-paced game in the northwest of Western Australia there.
Might come back and have a look at that in a bit more detail. The West Kimberley Football League team to beat, though, once again looks to be Cable Beach, and Kate Ryan from GWN7 filed this story.
With six players out, the Saints performed a promising first quarter but couldn't keep it up for the entire game. Last year's premiers, Cable Beach, were just too good together.
Blokes are working together and look really, really positive today. The build-up to the game was really positive.
It was clear Cable Beach were communicating better throughout the match, while the Saints appeared to lack structure and confidence, causing them to play catch-up.
Our club's just, the whole team so far is just starting to bond throughout this first round, and hopefully the next round we will get better.
With their confidence showing through in their play, Cable Beach is on track to finishing in the finals again this season.
We're halfway through the season nearly, and I think we're just starting to, it's taken 6 weeks to get where we are, and I think we're better than what we were.
Cable Beach 10-9-69 defeated the Saints 6-3-39. In the rest of the round, the Bulls demolished Towns by 53 points. The Peninsula Bombers beat the Derby Tigers by a couple of goals, and the Luma Eagles just beat the Bidjiganga Emus. Bidjiganga's on top of the ladder with no losses. The Bulls, Saints and Cable Beach are all on 4 wins and 2 losses. Derby's down the bottom with no wins and 6 losses. Kate Ryan for GWN 7 News, reporting for Off the Bench TV.
Yeah, thanks very much. Geez, the wintering conditions have to test you, don't they, Ash?
Oh, they do. The mud, the wet. Yeah.
Spoiled for weather in WA, that is for sure. So well done to Kate. Great story there. The interleague game that you mentioned, it's a massive game coming up this weekend, Ross.
Yes, it is. And just to cover off the details, we've got them here for you. It'll be held at the Rovers Football Club in Port Hedland tomorrow at 6 p.m. That'll be a huge game. The best of both leagues, of course, on show in that one. And plenty of exciting talent in both competitions.
Look forward to, if you're in the area, make sure you go and have a look. What about the results from Round 8 in the Goldfields Footy League, Ross?
Yes, let's have a look at this one. Boulder City, very easy winners over Cambolda. It was the second time the teams have met this season. A slightly better result for Cambolda this time around, reducing the margin from more than that, 200 plus the first time to 193 this time. 12 different goal kickers for Boulder City, 11 of whom kicked more than one major. Jaden Zilm was the best of them with 5 goals. Chris Bowie and Scott Worthington had 4 apiece, and Jamie Hayes kicked Cambolda's only goal there. The next game of the round was Kalgoorlie City defeating Mines Rovers. Kalgoorlie City booted 4-1 in the first quarter, and that quick start proved the difference in this game. Rovers went on to outscore the Kangas in the second and third quarters, but just couldn't reel them in. Good result for the Kangas. They fell 7 goals short of Rovers in back in round 3. Dale Beeson and Darren Coyle kicked 2 each for the winners, and Jack Varian was best of field.
All right, nicely done. Let's have a look at the ladder, Roz.
Let's do that. Boulder City and the reigning premiers Mines Rovers deadlocked at the top of the table with 5 wins each, but they're still still a long way to go in the 20-round season. The Kangas look to be the other challenger this year. Cambalda still without a win. This Sunday seems a bottom-of-the-table clash between Cambalda and Railways, but given that in their round four meeting, it was a 127-point win to Rovers, to Railways, rather, you'd expect this game to be pretty one-sided as well.
Comprehensive, as always. Beautifully done, Roz. Boulder City having a nice year on top of the ladder, and one man that's having a pivotal role is Scotty Worthington, and he's been kind enough to join us on the phone tonight. Scotty, welcome.
How you going?
Yeah, we're going pretty well. Not as well as you, though. You personally and the team are having a good start to the year.
Yeah, it's been pretty positive, mate. We've haven't got a loss on the board yet, so no, it's been a good start, and hopefully continue it on this week.
Now, Scotty, I've got to ask, you won two flags in your waffle career with the Subiaco Footy Club, including last year's grand final, but in a move that's very similar to LeBron James coming from Miami Heat to the Cleveland Cavaliers, you've come back home. Can you talk us through the decision for that?
Oh, I think they're on largely different scales, those two, but no, it's just good to be home, mate. I had a bit of work opportunity to come home and come back to the country, so no, it's been a good move so far.
Scotty, how are you finding the standard in the Goldfields Footy League? It seems it's a bit of the haves and have-nots in the competition so far this season.
Yeah, it's obviously a little bit different than what I've been playing the last 2 years, which is fine, but you do get some very, very good footballers down here at the moment. You just tailor off on your sort of last couple of players, but no, it's a very good standard, Danny.
Now, Scotty, you're averaging nearly four goals a game, but on the weekend there was that 193-point victory and you only kicked four. I'm hoping there are a few score assists in there.
Mate, I played on the wing for a bit just to change it up and even got thrown down back, which I had to make my own move there. I wasn't too happy with that one.
I understand your mum might be still involved with the footy club and even the league. Scotty, tell us a bit about that, and was that part of the draw card of going home?
Yeah, mum's still involved. She does a ton of work for Boulder and around the GFL as well, but dad is president again. So he was president of our last flag in 2005, I think it was. And yeah, having him back at the helm was a big draw card.
All right, Scotty, mum's the secretary. She's the jack of all trades. The old man's the president. What's the market for you winning this year's B&F? Sounds like your short price favourite so far.
I think it hinders me, mate. I think it hinders me.
Well, you're doing some pretty good stuff for the Boulder City. Congratulations on your season to date, and we wish you all the very best for not only this weekend, but also for the rest of the year. Congratulations. Keep it up.
Beautiful. Thanks for having me, guys.
There you go, Scotty Worthington, having a great year. Who I might also add was our first nominee for our West Coast Poly Player of the Year Award. So well done to Scotty. Before we bid you farewell, Roz, let's have a look at the fixtures in the Goldfields League for round nine.
That's right. This weekend, Boulder City will play host to Kalgoorlie City. Cambalda will take on Railways, and Mines Rovers has the bye.
Great to have you on the show. Look forward to seeing you again next week.
Thanks very much.
All right, thanks to Roz. Time to take a look at our Dial Before You Dig first step to stardom. Dial Before You Dig, the essential first step in any excavation. Visit the website 1100.com.au or call 1100 anytime. This week, we are focusing on Sam Petrevski-Seaton, a young midfielder from the Halls Creek in the northwest of WA. If you think of Cyril Rioli and think of Stephen Hill, then that's all you've got to think. This kid has all the skills. So well done to Sam to be this week's Dial Before You Dig nominee. Off the Bench WA, proudly brought to you by McDonald's. Maccas is WA footy, and McDonald's are certainly proud to be able to foster and grow the great game across all levels in WA, from grassroots to community clubs to elite level organisations through their football partnership portfolio. And a very warm Friday night cheerio to a couple of key players in the McDonald's franchisees world over in WA, and that is Richard Hill and Johnny Frankham, doing some great stuff. And thanks for your sponsorship to make this show possible for our WA audiences. Also very good to have you in the chair, Ash. You've looked after yourself. You've kept yourself in really good nick in the off-season. Unlike Scotty Cummings, who, if you're wondering why he's not in the chair, overweight, unfit. Got to get it right. He'll come back and he'll take that place when he's in good physical condition. Hey, Ash, why don't we have a look at some Round 7 results from the South West Footy League from the weekend?
Well, we've recorded our first draw of the year. Harvey Brunswick and the Collie Eagles all tying up at 34 apiece.
Next,
Next, the Eton Boomers won their first game of the year, defeating Augusta Margaret River by 60 points.
Ramsey with 5, good effort.
Now, this is the big one. The Harvey Bulls have snapped the undefeated streak of the South Bunbury Tigers, defeating them by 24 points.
Yeah, we're going to have a talk to the coach of South Bunbury very shortly. What about the next game?
And in the grand final rematch, Busselton defeated Carey Park with the Magpies winning by 25 points.
And we've got some big games coming up very shortly. We'll get to that shortly. Bunbury, though, a good win.
Yeah, they've dominated Donnybrook, keeping them goalless in the first half to win by 41 points.
What about the ladder in this particular footy league? It's good at the top.
It is, and nothing much is really separating between 1 and 6 with only 2 wins. And we are going to talk about this big clash between South Bunbury, who's sitting first, and Bunbury, who is third at the moment.
Yeah, and the fixture for the long weekend in WA involves these teams.
Augusta Margaret River are playing Harvey Brunswick. The Collie Eagles are taking on Busselton. The Harvey Bulls will be taking on Carey Park. Donnybrook and the Eton Boomers. And South Bunbury versus Bunbury on that Monday.
The one on the bottom is the one that we're going to focus on because it's WA Day on Monday. It's a long weekend in WA. And the coach of South Bunbury, Mark Docking, has been kind enough to join us on a Friday night. A couple of days out from a big game of footy, 1v3. Lost one on the weekend last weekend. Mark, welcome and thanks for joining us.
Yeah, good evening, boys. Thanks for having us on.
Hey, it's a great story, your footy club. Finished 7th in 2015, but you sit on top with a massive game coming up on Monday against the third-place Bunbury.
Yeah, no, we've been fortunate enough to have a really good turnaround on our past performance, and some of the hard work of the past few years is really starting to pay off for us.
Mark, an ex-teammate of mine, Adam Hunter, obviously played there. I heard a lot about the great footy club. With the standalone clash on Monday, what opportunities does it present for the footy club?
Look, it's a really good opportunity for us to showcase some of our young talent. Both us and Bunbury are a young side, so it's a really good chance for the community to get out and see two good young footy teams go at it.
And off the back of that, the young talent, you've got a number of injuries at the moment. Has that promoted opportunity for these young kids? And who are some of the players that we should be making a note of?
Yeah, look, no, we'll have another young guy debut this weekend for us, 17-year-old Cody Evans. So he's a really tall, agile ruckman. So he'll be the exciting kid to watch. But, you know, you get injuries every year, and every week we try and send our best side out.
Big question, Mark. Can you beat them on Monday?
Yeah, we can.
How?
Look, I think we just need to perform across 4 quarters. We haven't put 4 quarters together yet, so we're confident in the style of play that we've got and the way we move the ball. And it's as long as we can put it together for 4 quarters, I think we'll come up with the 4 points.
Well, it's a massive game on WA Day on Monday. Standalone game against Bunbury. You're doing some good things. You're on top of the ladder. Bounce back from a loss last week. We wish you well, and thanks very much for joining us tonight.
Thanks, guys.
There you go, the coach of South Bunbury, Mark Docking. Adam Hunter, how's he going, your old mate?
He's going well. Going well? I'm going to be seeing him soon, hopefully at the reunion this year, so looking forward to catching up with a few of the guys.
Well, I reckon he's kept himself in good shape as opposed to somebody else who's not here at the moment. We're going to take a break. When we come back, I'm putting you under the torch. West Coast, good season. Fremantle, unbelievably bad season. Ash Hansen to tell us about those two teams when we come back for our final seg off the bench WA. Grumpy Ross, did he let the boys know at quarter time last weekend? No, I'm not happy, fellas. I need a bit more of a lift. Can you please give me effort? Can you please just put your body on the line? Show me as though it means something for this jumper. Nice old rocket.
It was.
Didn't mind it.
Sometimes you've got to do it.
They don't do it often anymore. I mean,
no,
you're a coach.
I am.
You're soft on them now. Did you ever
you're an educator, Swatter.
Oh, please. What does that mean? I couldn't even spell it. Hey, did you ever cop a bake from Woosha in your 78 great
Plural
games and a flag?
Two.
You
two.
Or the team?
No, the team.
Really?
Yep.
Wasn't a baker of individuals?
No.
Really?
Yep, he's a very collective man. What about yourself in your 282 games, Swatter?
I can't remember a game where I didn't get baked. There was a famous one, 97 prelim final. Got suspended for 4 weeks because a tagger fell underneath my boot. They charged me with stomping. Glenn Archer missed 2 weeks. Missed a prelim final. We lost. And Dennis Pagan gave me 15 minutes of his best.
Sorry for bringing it up.
No, it's okay. I still haven't got over it. So maybe I should at some point. Hey, more importantly, though, Frio, finished the home and away season at the end of last year, three games better off than any team in the home and away season, made the finals, made a prelim. Could anybody have expected or predicted the fact that at the end of round two in the following season, they would be zip 10?
You would have to be Nostradamus to predict what has happened to the Fremantle Footy Club this year. I certainly didn't see it coming, and I'm watching it very closely as a case study for how Ross Lyon deals with the remainder of the year, because it's foreign ground for us.
Absolutely. Now, there's a couple of things that have contributed. This is an ageing group that he's had. He's got them to the finals before without the ultimate glory. Significant injuries to your two key players. Nate Fyfe out for the season. Yep. Aaron Sanderlands with a rib injury. You've also had other injury concerns. They convinced Matthew Pavlich to come back out of retirement or stopped him from retiring. Yep. Is it that simplistic to say those are the reasons why they're in the position they are, or are there other extenuating circumstances?
I think it can be that simple. In a competition like today where it's so close and the competitive advantage is so minutely looking for, that those things can go a long way. But I can see Fremantle turn this around pretty quickly. I think we've seen Sydney continually be able to regenerate their list. They've got a core there. They've got a good coaching structure. So I think they've just got to go through this period.
All right, that's the Fremantle Dockers. What about your old club, the West Coast Eagles? At home, they're a very good team. The issue has been travelling on the road. Had a big win on the weekend against the Gold Coast Suns.
I went through this period in our career before we really start to threaten, and I think it's just their young players learning with the demands of travel, learning to feel comfortable in the state and to perform at the same level they do at home. So they're looking and searching for that consistency. I hope it doesn't start this week, but they should be able to find that pretty soon.
How big of an issue is the travel factor? At home, both of these teams historically have been better performed organisations, but travelling on the road and winning on the road has been problematic.
It's just a young mind feeling comfortable. And we say in football that so much of the game is played above the shoulders, and that's really amplified on the road. These players going away from home 2 days out from a game, because I know the West Coast structure, I'm sure they'll turn around and they'll learn from it.
Great to have you on board. You've been a really excellent performer. So you've lifted the standards, which wasn't that hard considering who you're filling in for. Thanks to McDonald's WA off the bench. Back next week. Have a great weekend.